Thank you, Lord, for the flowers that are blooming and the palm trees that surround me and your beautiful sky. Thank you, Lord, for each day you've given me, each day you've blessed me with. Thank you for the beautiful view in the marina hood of my backyard. And the plants that, the cutting I was given that became a larger banana tree. And for a new day, another new day. Like a little kid looking up at the sky, just enjoying the beauty you've surrounded me with. Thank you, Lord, I'm alive. Thank you, Lord, that you're so good to me, that even though some days I walk in such complete faith and don't know what the next step is, that each step that I take, you're faithful to meet me there and take care of me along the way. Thank you, Lord, for my wonderful family and friends. Thank you, Lord, that I have a nice, humble yacht to stay on while I'm working on the book. May everything that I say bring glory to you. Thank you, Lord, that even though things aren't perfect, I'm making progress. And that each step of the way, even though there's a few missing pieces, this is so funny, I found the cushions that they short one section. So I'm happy to at least have what I have until Walmart gets somewhere in and I can finish the complete set and have guests. I'm thankful for the women that came the other night and sat and spoke with me from Pastor Jose's church in Conroe, Texas. And we sat here, and even though we were a cushion missing, we made do, and we had a nice fellowship. Thank you for fellowship. Thank you for Chris Barron and Doris Ward of the Barron Ward band I'm managing, and their creative style, and what a blessing it is to have them in my life, that we can create things together. And for my precious friends that introduced me to them, Henry, Dortha, Billy, all of those people that were part of William Downing's life, who's now deceased, that the guys play in tribute to. I thank you, Lord, that whatever I do will be glory to you. Let me finish this book, and I'm imperfect, but I put it in your hands, Lord. I just give it to you that somehow my imperfect words you will use to touch somebody's life, to help someone else, to encourage someone else, to bless my family and friends and those that might read it, and that it will be something for my grandchildren to remember me by, that will bless them. And she will give me wisdom of what to do, whether to sell this outboard and get a smaller one so I can have it for my dinghy. Thank you, Lord, for wisdom, knowledge, understanding, health, and wholeness, for guiding my footsteps and my family. I thank you, Lord, that your family and friends, you're watching over them, protecting them, guiding them, helping them to come closer to you, helping us all to make a positive difference in the world and help each other. Thank you, Lord, for all the exchange students I hosted over the years that are all across the country, that all across the world, that brought joy to my life, and I hopefully brought some joy to their life. I thank you that each and every one of them become successful men and women, and that my girl who I sponsored to Compassion International, that turned 18 this month, a shout out to Meseret, with loves and love hugs in Ethiopia. And pray for all those who have lost their homes in the hurricanes or flooding. May you help restore them and turn around the things that have happened to them that seem horrible. Turn it around for good. Bless all the people that have been sowing into their lives, whether it be the neighbor, loved ones, family members, friends, churches, outreaches, everyone, first responders, Cajun Navy, National Guard, everybody that helped with that. May they be blessed for all the assistance. And those in authority over us, in our leaders, Lord, I thank you that you're watching over our leaders. And yes, President Trump and his wife and family and all of the leaders that are above us, that are doing their best to make our lives better, whether we understand exactly or not. Help us to have peace. Help us all to get along and love one another. Let none of us see color. Let us just see our hearts, just like you look at us, Lord. You look at our hearts, you don't look at our outside appearance. I thank you for that, Lord. Because I sure... I'm getting older and I'm not exactly the most beautiful outside anymore as we all are when we're younger. But I'm just grateful for the love that we have through you, our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Thank you for the Holy Spirit to help guide me, protect me, give me discernment, direction, help me make wise choices, and help me to be able to accomplish what you've called me to do during this season of my life. I sometimes don't always like being in some of the places that you've sent me, but you've always turned it around for better, so I trust you. I trust and obey. And I'm thankful, Lord, for all you've blessed me with, even though I sometimes have cried and prayed and not understood. You've always been so faithful to me, Lord. You've always taken the little I've had and multiplied it. You've given me such joy with beautiful grandbabies and children and daughter-in-laws and nieces, nephews. Just thank you, God, for all those things that you've blessed me with. That I have peace in you. I can rest in you, Lord. When all the storms come, all the craziest things that happen in the world happen, I can always depend on you to give me peace. Thank you, Lord, for your love, mercy, grace. Thank you for anyone who ever watches this, even though it's really a prayer to the Lord. Just hope it blesses someone or encourages someone else to. Someone that needs to know they're loved. Wrap them in your arms, Lord. Let them feel your presence. Let them know that you are there for them through everything. God bless you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. I am extremely grateful for you being in my life, because otherwise I'd be a basket case. I would not been able to make it through single parenting, Hurricane Katrina, Rita, Harvey, or dealing with the Irma hitting my state, or all the other stuff. Growing up trying to be an entrepreneur at such a young age before it was cool, and dealing with womanizers, you helped me get through it all. And bless me with some good friendships. And it's been a blessing to watch my friends, my pastor friends, kids grow up and continue what you've called them to do. And just bless all of them, Lord. Bless them all, everyone that has faithfully continued to just sow into people's lives in one way or another, whether pastoring or just the average person on the street doing acts of kindness to help each other get through the challenging times.